Jesus, every breath I take, I breathe in you. Oh, that was weak. That was way weak. You guys got to help me out a little bit. I need like a good whoop, whoo. Can I do that? Let's see if you guys can do it. Ready? One, two, three. Whoop. I need one more. I need a better one than that. Y'all going to have to help me out. One, two, three. That was a little better. Let's see if y'all can do it better this time.
Every move I make in you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take.
Here we go. There you go.
Every step I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in hell of your waves. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. So, oh my God, this love, how can it be?
Okay, so I need one volunteer. Somebody who knows the waves. You right there. What's her name? Rachel's her name? Okay, state your name.
I'm Rachel.
I'll give it up for Rachel here. Okay, so you know the motions of this song, right? Okay, and you can lead these beautiful people in these motions, right? Rachel, do you guys want Rachel to lead you this morning? Yeah? Okay, so it goes like this. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your beautiful faces. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? Y'all give it up for Rachel, all right? She's gonna help you. Okay, so you guys mimic her, okay? You got this, Rachel? You got this? All right, here we go. Let's sing Waves of Mercy. One, two, hey,
hey. Waves of mercy, waves of grace. I breathe in you.
Here we go, waves of mercy.
So waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me, oh God. Oh my God, this love, how can it be? Na 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 na.
So Rachel, I need your help one more time. So this is what we're gonna do, okay? I know that you junior high kids are just like stinking loud all the time, okay? So this is what I need you to do, okay? I need this right here in the center. We're gonna split over there, and y'all go over there, okay? So split right in the middle. All right? That means you two in the green shirt, you go over that way. You go over that way. All right? Split. Split. That means move, move, move. There you go. You guys are smart. You can do this. That means move over to with this side. Y'all move over to this with this side right over here. You guys move over with this side over here, okay? Y'all make a big group, okay? Okay? Okay, so this is basically a contest to see who can be loud, okay? And here's the deal, okay? Here's the deal. Whoever's loudest, you guys listen up. This is important. Whoever's loudest gets to get in line for lunch first, okay? Okay? So this is how it's gonna go. You're gonna help me judge this, Rachel, okay? Okay? So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna sing na 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 really, really loud. And whatever group is loudest wins, okay? Does that make sense? Okay, so I'm gonna count you off. Let me see. Are we fair on both sides? I think we are. You guys think you can keep up with them? Yeah? Y'all seem pretty weak right now. You guys think you can keep up with them? Yeah? Okay. Do you guys think you can beat them? Woo! Y'all better step it up. Here we go. I'm going to count you off, or y'all going to start off first. You ready? One, two, ready, go! Y'all can beat them. Y'all think you're better? One, two, ready, go! I'll give you one more chance. One, two, ready, go! One more time, over here. Here we go. What do you think? Oh, Rachel, what do you think? Well, the judges are gonna talk for just a minute. You wanna try it one more time, Rachel? Should we try it one more time? All right, we're gonna try this one more time, okay? We're gonna give you a chance to redeem yourselves over here, because y'all are doing pretty bad, okay? I'm just saying, okay? All right, here we go. You guys need a Red Bull or something, don't you, man? Come on. We're gonna try this one more time, you ready? One, two, ready, go! Can y'all get it? Ready, go! All right, this time, everybody do it. One, two, ready, go! Na, 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 na. Man, okay. I'm just gonna say, you guys killed it. You guys killed it. Okay, so during lunch today, you guys get in line first, okay? Is that cool with the leaders? Yeah? Yeah, is that cool? Y'all give it up for Rachel. She did a great job judging here. Okay, so y'all find your seats. Let's sing that na-na together one more time. Here we go. One, two, eight, go. Na-na-na-na-na-na. Na-na-na-na-na-na.
As we wait upon the Lord, wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord, wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You do not think you won't go weary. Oh, your rising center of the weak, comfort those who need. You lift us up on. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon our God. You reign forever. He's our hope, He's our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God, the everlasting God. You do not think you won't grow. our strong deliverer. You sing that loudly. You are the everlasting God. Cause you are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not think you won't grow weary, Lord. You're a defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles. You are the everlasting. Comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
Amen. So bless the Lord.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and oh my soul. Worship your holy name. Sing like ever before. And oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before, let me be singing when the evening comes. You bless the Lord, to bless the Lord, oh my soul, to oh my soul, I worship His Lord. Like ever before, and to all my soul, I worship your holy name. You're rich in love, and you're slow to anger. Your name is great, and your heart is kind. Well, for all your goodness, I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to fly. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before. I worship your holy name, oh bless the Lord, so bless the Lord, oh my soul, I worship His holy name. So sing like never, sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy.
So I like this. I like what the song says, because it says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul." And when we think about a soul, it's what I think about is really our soul kind of makes up everything about who we are. It makes up the decisions we make. It makes up the emotions we're feeling, and the thoughts that we think, and the actions that we do. Everything about us is kind of summed up in this whole soul being, you know. So as we're saying, bless the Lord, oh my soul, we're saying, God, with everything that I am, everything, my thoughts, my actions, the things that I look at, the things that I take in, everything about us is saying, bless the Lord. That's a big statement for us, you guys. So let's sing that again. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And think about what that means. Not only just here. This isn't just a song, man. This is the song of our life. So as we leave here, as we interact with people, as we go home, as we interact with our family, with our parents, as we go back to school this next year, we're talking about everything about us. We're blessing the Lord with that. We're worshiping God with everything we have. So bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and O my soul. I worship His holy name. And sing like never before, and O my soul. I worship Your holy name. And on that day, when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul sees Your praise unending. 10,000 years and live forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. I worship His holy name. I sing like never before, and oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. I worship His holy name. I sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Worship Your holy name, Lord. I will worship Your holy name.
God, that's the cry of our heart, Lord. We want to worship You with everything that we have, God. So, Lord, as we look at Your word, we look at examples of people who are heroes, God. People who stood up for not only what was easy, God, but what was right, Lord. And those things, along with Your righteousness, Lord, made them righteous, God. With the acts that they did, Lord, the fact that they chose to honor You, Lord, and be righteous people. God, we want that, Lord. We want everything within us, as we sang, everything about us, Lord, our souls, Lord, everything, to worship and to bless Your name. So Lord, thank You, God. Thank You for letting us meet with You this morning, God. Be with us as we open Your word. Mary Jane teaches us this morning. We say this in Your powerful name. Amen. Guys, take a seat.
Hey, good morning, guys. I am so excited to see y'all this morning. Seeing your beautiful faces every morning has been a great way to start every day here. I just want you all to know that. Thank you for being here at this assembly, and I think you guys have a really fun day planned ahead on your schedule. So today we're going to learn about a new hero, and her name is Wonder Woman. Who knows about Wonder Woman? Tell us about Wonder Woman. There she is. You probably know more about that than I do. We'll go with that. Whatever you say about Wonder Woman.
I know that she's an Amazon, and that she is the princess.
And she is a woman with extraordinary powers that did not know she had extraordinary powers. And so today we're going to meet a Wonder Woman of the Bible named Esther. Y'all know about Esther?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I want to share a word of scripture with you from Esther this morning, from Esther chapter 4. Listen for how God may be speaking to you this day. When Mordecai learned what had been done, he ripped his clothes to shreds and put on sackcloth and ashes. Then he went out in the streets of the city, crying out in loud and bitter cries. He came only as far as the king's gate, for no one dressed in sackcloth was allowed to enter the king's gate. As the king's order was posted in every province, there was loud lament among the Jews, fasting, weeping, and wailing, and most of them stretched out on sackcloth and ashes. Esther's maids and eunuchs came and told her the queen was stunned. She sent fresh clothes to Mordecai so he could take off his sackcloth, but he couldn't accept them. Esther called for Hatak, one of the royal eunuchs whom the king had assigned to wait on her, and told him to go to Mordecai and get the full story of what was happening. So he went to Mordecai in the town square in front of the king's gate. Mordecai told him everything that had happened to him. He also told him the exact amount of money that Haman had promised to deposit in the royal bank to finance the massacre of the Jews. Mordecai also gave him a copy of the bulletin that had been posted in Susa ordering the massacre so he could show it to Esther when he reported back with instructions to go to the king and intercede and plead with him for her people. Hatak came back and told Esther everything Mordecai had said. Esther talked it over with him and then sent him back to Mordecai with this message. Everyone who works for the king here, and even the people out in the provinces, knows that there is a single fate for every man or woman who approaches the king without being invited, and that is death. The one exception is if the king extends his gold scepter. Then he or she may live. And it's been 30 days now since I've been invited to come to the king. When Hatak told Mordecai what Esther had said, Mordecai sent her this message. Don't think that just because you live in the king's house, you are the one Jew who will get out of this alive. If you persist in staying silent at a time like this, help and deliverance will arrive for the Jews from someplace else. But you and your family will be wiped out. Who knows? Maybe you were made queen for just such a time as this. Esther sent back her answer to Mordecai. Go and get all the Jews living in Susa together. Fast for me. Don't eat or drink for 3 days, either day or night. I and my maids will fast with you. If you will do this, I'll go to the king, even though it's forbidden. If I die, then I die. This is the word of God for the people of God. Would you pray with me? Holy God, we come to you this morning with hearts filled with excitement for what this day may bring. We ask your presence among us and your Holy Spirit to be here with us as we learn more about what being a hero means. That we don't have to have extraordinary powers to do extraordinary things. For God, you too have called us to such a time as this. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be pleasing to you. O God, for you are our rock and our redeemer. In the name of our precious Savior, we pray. Amen. Well, do you know what exciting event happened 2 years ago? I'll give you a hint. Girls, you may know this a little more than the boys. It was the royal wedding. Did you watch it? No, I know you boys probably didn't watch it. Well, yes, Prince William and Kate Middleton, If you're even alive and breathing, you surely know who they are. My daughter, Taylor, is obsessed with the royal family. She has for years wanted to marry Prince William, but she was really okay with Kate Middleton marrying him. Now she set her sights on Prince Harry. But we got up at 3:30 in the morning on the day of their wedding and watched the whole thing several times. I made all this English breakfast food. We had tea and scones, and then we even had our own little wedding reception. These are things, superhero things that moms do for their kids, I guess. But we had a little wedding cake and the whole nine yards. So now we have another big royal event coming up. Who knows who that is? It's a baby, right? They're having a baby any minute now. So before I left to come here and be with you, Taylor and I decided to have a baby shower for Princess Kate. We didn't get her gifts or anything, but we did have a cake. And so when I ordered the cake, I had on it HRH baby, his or her royal highness, because we don't know if it's a boy or a girl, right? So we had the cake half pink and half blue. So this is a thing we do together, and it's fun, and she gets a kick out of it, and I get a kick out of it because she gets a kick out of it. So we celebrate this royal baby and all that that means. Well, today when we meet Esther, the royal family, Princess Kate and Prince William, is like a fairy tale, right? A handsome young prince marries a commoner. Well, Esther also became a queen and became a member of a royal family. And Esther was a beautiful young woman, actually not much older than many of you. She was very likely only in her late teens or just past that when she married King Xerxes. So she was chosen for this role out of hundreds and hundreds of women who spent weeks and weeks prepping and doing all kinds of beauty treatments, and then the king chose her. Well, Esther was raised by Mordecai, who is her cousin, and they were raised in a time, it was 500 years before Christ. Well, 100 years earlier, the Jewish people had been taken into exile in Babylon. And 50 years before that, Babylon had conquered the Persians. A little bit of a history lesson. And the Jewish people were allowed to come home. But it still wasn't safe to be a Jew in those days. So Esther and Mordecai hid the fact that they were Jewish. They didn't want people to know. So even her new husband, the king, did not know that she was Jewish. So Jewish people were always in danger of being found out, and they had one enemy, who particularly in the king's realm, and his name was Haman. And he thought himself to be the king's right-hand man, to be the person that the king turned to, who had all the answers and all the wisdom. And he and Mordecai, Esther's cousin, didn't like each other very well at all. But Haman had a plot to wipe out the entire Jewish population. Esther's people were all going to be killed. But they had one hope, and that was Esther. And Mordecai, in our scripture, told her about this terrible plight against the Jews. And she said to him, do you remember? She said, but in this royal court, all is not what it seems. She hadn't even had an audience with the king in 30 days. That was a huge deal. So she didn't think she had any say-so or any right or any ability to go to the king and fight for her people. She knew how important this was, but she was afraid. So she asked them to enter a time of fasting and of prayer. But Mordecai said to her, Esther, maybe there's a reason that you became queen. And he said to her, for you were made for such a time as this. You are the Wonder Woman for this time and situation. It is only you who can help us. And so finally she said, okay. These are my people. This is the right thing to do. If I die, I die. So be it. So be it. And at the heart of this story and of Queen Esther, I think it makes our stomachs turn a little bit and our breath gets short, because perhaps each and every one of us have been at that moment in time where we were in the right place at the right time, and there was something meant for us to do. Think about what you would do in a situation where you were faced with the very thing you feared the most. What would you do? What would you do in that moment? Here's what Esther did. Chapter 7, verses 1 through 6. So the king and Haman went to dinner with Queen Esther. At the second dinner, while they were drinking wine, the king again asked, "Queen Esther, what would you like?" Because he loved her so much, he would give her anything she asked for. "Half of my kingdom, just ask, and it is yours." Queen Esther answered him, "If I have found favor in your eyes, O king, and if it pleases the king, give me my life and give my people their lives too. We've been sold, I and my people, to be destroyed, sold to be massacred and eliminated. If we had just been sold off into slavery, I wouldn't have even brought it up. Our troubles wouldn't have been worth bothering the king over." And King Xerxes got mad and exploded, and he said, "Who? Where is he? Who is this monstrous one? An enemy, an adversary, the evil Haman," said Esther. Esther saw her God-given opportunity, and she seized it, but not without difficulty and not without fear. But ultimately, she took courage and put on her crown of being a queen in this royal family. She put on her Wonder Woman superhero cape, and she just did it. What do we do when we are facing our utmost fears? Or when we face what we believe to be places where we don't feel good enough? Like Esther, when she said, "I don't have all this clout with the king. I don't really have all the right stuff to do this." She told her cousin, "You don't really understand what our relationship is like." In her mind. But she was Wonder Woman in that situation. Friends, we all have something. By virtue of the fact that we are breathing and we're alive, we have something to offer. And you may think, "I'm too young," or "I'm too inexperienced." Remember the other day when I confessed to you what my greatest fear was, that I grew up very, very shy, and speaking in public was not anything I ever saw myself doing? Well, the other thing is that when I grew up, church was not really a part of my life. I grew up in a different tradition. I grew up in the Baptist church, a Southern Baptist church, in a little small town in Arkansas. And I am grateful for that. That's where I was baptized, and that's where I say I first learned Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. So I am so grateful for that. But I was not a very good Baptist, and I was not a very good churchgoer. I didn't like it. I didn't want to go. I wasn't surrounded by people who supported me. I didn't have youth ministers. I didn't have people that supported me and nurtured me all through that journey. So when I got to a place in my life where nobody was making me go, I stopped going. And so for many years of my young life, church was not a part of it. Now, I thought Jesus and I were pretty tight, but church had no place in my life. So it is only by a miracle of God that I became a minister. I was the last person on the planet I thought would ever do this. But I was there somewhere along the way in my journey for just such a time as this. And it was through some tough things happening in my life that I realized the importance it was of having a community of faith. So what would you do if you were faced with your biggest fears? What would you do? What are some of your biggest fears? You don't have to shout them out. Just think about it. Because the how of what we do is not up to us. It's our response, just like Queen Esther, of saying, okay, whatever happens, happens, God. I am in your hands. Because in each and every one of you are awesome possibilities. You can do anything, and you don't have to have exceptional powers to do exceptional and extraordinary things. But just remember that you too, just like Esther, have been chosen for such a time as this. Would you pray with me? Oh God, we thank you always for putting us in just the right places where we need to be in our lives, in just the right times. Help us, oh God, to know what those things are that make us feel like we are not enough to do what you call us to do, that make us feel fearful and concerned and worried. Are we too young? Are we too old? Are we not pretty enough, smart enough, rich enough? Whatever it is, oh God, it doesn't matter. Help us, like our hero of the day, to say, whatever happens, happens, God, for we are in your hands. And you can do extraordinary things through us. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Jesus, you endured my pain. Savior, you bore all my shame. To all because of your love. Maker of the universe, broken for the sins of the earth. To all because of your love. To all because of your love. Because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love, I live. Yes, I live. Innocent and holy King, you died to set the captives free. It's all, because of your love. Lord, you gave your life for me, so I will. So I will live my life for you, God. It's all because of your love. It's all because of your love, your love. Because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your blood, my sins are washed away. And now all of my life I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love, I live. Yes, I. For me, you did it for love. It's your victory, Jesus. You are enough. You did it for me. You did it for love. It's your victory, Jesus. You are enough. You did it for me. You did it for life, Lord. It's your victory. Jesus, you are enough. You did it for me. Oh, you did it for life. It's your victory. Jesus, you are alive. Because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your blood, my sins are washed away. And now all of my life, I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love, because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your life, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life, I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love, I with me. Beautiful Jesus. Beautiful Jesus. Beautiful Savior. Lord, nothing is greater. Brilliant Creator. Friend of mine. You're powerful. Above this world, the universe is under your command. Your glory shines, a holy light that leads our hearts to praise your name. That leads our heart to praise your holy name. Yes, I live for beautiful Jesus, beautiful Savior, Lord. Nothing is greater, brilliant Creator, friends of mine. He's perfect in power. Perfect in power, matchless in glory. Oh, you are. So nothing is greater. Really, Creator, friends of mine. My lips will sing. My lips will sing. My heart will bring praise to you. The Holy King, my lips will sing, my heart will bring praise to you, Holy.
So for just a minute, I want to challenge you guys, and I'm challenging myself as well. What we're saying here, we're saying, my lips will sing and my heart will bring praise to you, the Holy King. And so what I think that we tend to do, and I think that we all tend to do, is we come into a worship service and we kind of get this mindset that, man, this is about me, you know. We come into this time where we're just like, I'm tired, or, you know, I've got things on my mind, or, I don't like the songs that they're doing, or I'm not really into this. And we make this whole worship experience about us, And the truth is, man, our worship is about God. We need to remember that. And so we're saying our lips will sing and our heart will bring praise to you, the Holy King. So what we're singing is not just empty words just coming out of our mouths. We're saying, God, my heart, everything within me, just like we talked about, our soul is going to worship you. And so I want to challenge you guys. What I like to think about is not only inwardly is this going on, but outwardly I'm expressing my worship to God. So I want to encourage you students that if you go into one of the senior high services we have, man, you see these students engaging. They're engaging in worship. And I want to encourage you guys to do that, whether it looks like you're raising your hand or singing out. Man, this is an outward expression of an inward reality. So what we're saying is we're expressing outwardly what's going on inside our hearts and what we believe. So I want to encourage you guys to not just be spectators of this, not just to stand there and just be like, I'm singing these songs, because sometimes that's what it looks like. And I want to encourage you to enter in with us. We want to have this worship experience together and sing together and express what God's doing in our hearts. So let's sing that one more time. My lips will sing and my heart will bring praise to you, the Holy King.
My lips will sing and my heart will bring praise to you, the Holy King. My lips will sing, my heart will bring praise to you, Holy, oh. My lips will sing and my heart will bring praise to you, the Holy King. My lips will sing, my heart will ring praise to you, Holy. My lips will sing, my heart will ring praise to you, the Holy King. My lips will sing, my heart.
Amen. Father, we are thankful, God, that there's nothing greater than your name, God, in all the earth and all the heavens, Lord, everywhere. Lord, nothing is greater than your name, God. Will we outwardly express, God, what's inwardly going on inside us, God? Lord, will you change us from the inside out, God? We want to be renewed and transformed by you, God, so that our worship, Lord, Lord, is an outward expression, Lord, that we're always engaged, Lord, in bringing praise to you, God. Lord, thank you so much for my friends here. Thank you for letting us worship you, God. We say this in your name. Amen.
Okay, there was some money found on a couch in Smith, so if you lost money, then you can go to Miss B and tell her the exact amount of the money that you lost, and if it matches the money she found, then she'll give you your money back. Go to small groups.